What up, what up? Welcome back to the channel. I'm MoedotJ and we're locked in. This is the last day of our 8-day recap of the madness on Netflix, and we're trying to do 31 days of either Netflix shows or movies on my channel for the month of December. And right now, this is day 8. Now, this is the finale. You guys, let's just tune in and let's just woosah, because it's been about 13 or 19 days since he got fired from CNN, and we're finally piecing this together. But before we jump into this and we break down the finale of The Madness on Netflix, if you like this kind of content, if you want to stick around for this Netflix run that we got, 31 days of Netflix shows or movies, then hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so you get something every time I upload. Make sure you hit that like button. I'm on that road to 75,000 subscribers, so I appreciate each and every one of you. So let's go ahead and jump into it. This is No More Madness, the series finale on Netflix of The Madness. I'm MoedotJ. Let's go. As we left episode 7, we know that Julia is sneaking up on Isaiah. She's going straight assassin mode. Now, this is supposed to be top security, but he has on some moccasins. He ain't really out here watching around. Julia then creeped up to the car. She got a pistol with a silencer on. He stands up with his toolie. He ain't even prepared. She takes out the first guard. Isaiah told Elena and them they need to be quiet and get up out of here. He goes downstairs. Well, he goes upstairs to go look and see if Julia's in there because they've been hiding in the basement. As soon as he comes around the corner, he gets hit in the shoulder and Isaiah falls all the way down the stairs like he ain't got no damn sense. I'm talking feet over head, head over feet, hitting every single stair. And we're like, damn, that was the last weapon we had in the house too, man. Come on, Isaiah, pull through. Now that Julia has the upper hand, she's looking for Elena because we need to get some kind of leverage on Muncie. Well, Elena is waiting. She has some kind of object and bow, knocks Julia down to the ground. I'm talking about first swing, perfect, trifecta. The only thing is Julia, she ain't out yet. You start hearing the silencers go off. She gets hit one time. Oh, shit. She swings again and she's trying to finish off Julia, but Julia takes one more shot and it grazes her in the neck. Now, Julia, she doesn't make it. Elena, she's holding on for dear life. She's getting a phone call from Muncie. At the hospital, Muncie is talking to his family. Well, they're a little distant. And then the officers come in and they're starting to ask him, all right, what do you got going on? Because they're going over, Julia's on the live. He's like, listen, I got this recording here. This is her confessing to everything. Robert is who we need to go after, revitalize. It's crazy, but I got all of it. So the cops are saying, okay, we'll look into this and we'll try to do a little more of an investigation. We need that thumb drive. Now his lawyer is there also, and he's the one that actually put it on the thumb drive for him. So it's looking like all of our drama and troubles are over. The police have it. We're in good hands, guys. The only problem is when the FBI takes this information, since Franco isn't around anymore, they say that Julia and Don did all the murdering. They don't even take it up the ladder to Robert. So he's looking like, what? He's supposed to be getting his house together for his son to come stay with him. But he finds out that the FBI just dropped everything that he said. They saying that that audio recording of her, it can't be used. It can't be verified because she's not here to say that that was her. So right now, Julia and Don, they're the ones charged for all of those murders, but neither one of them are here. So no one's getting charged and Robert is walking free. Elena finally wakes up in the hospital and Muncie comes back and talks to her. Now, this is a good thing. We've seen that they were getting close. They even gave each other a kiss. But it turns out when Elena's recovering, she's saying, listen, after I get healthy, I need you to give me and Demetrius some space. You can keep Demetrius with you and take care of him until I get better. But after that, you just need to step back and leave us alone. Now, Muncie's thinking, I just did all of this for the family, and this is the thanks I get? You push me further away? Man, you just can't win. As he's leaving the hospital, a black man that works for Robert shows up, and it turns out he's a personal lawyer for Robert. Now, remember, Robert is a billionaire. He's the one that hired Julia. So what they have is an NDA here, non-disclosure agreement, where you can't talk about anything you think you know about Robert. Or you just shut up, take this $5 million, and you be quiet. Now, $5 million sounds very tempting right now, but Demetrius said, the hell with this. I just lost my wife. After everything I've been through, he takes the NDA and tells him, F off. We ain't signing no NDA. Questy, his lawyer, is saying, what do you think about that NDA? Of course, Muncie doesn't want to do it because he feels if I sign that NDA, even if they give me that $5 million, they will still come after me because they know I know. So I'll have to live the rest of my life looking over my shoulders, making sure that my doors are locked. Now, Questy is saying that is true. So what are you going to do? You going to go on CNN and expose all of this? Because if you do expose a little bit of it to the national media, this will maybe make them fall back and they might offer you more money or they might just fall back completely. But either way, you'll be good to go. So this is a route to get on CNN because they have asked for him to have an expose all conversation, especially after they fired him. With everything going on, Muncie decides to make a stop over at Franco's little memorial, and it's at the bowling alley, one of his favorite places. Now, his partner comes over, and remember, he let Franco out to dry when they were out there trying to say, this is all the information we have. Lori and Muncie been helping us out. We got information on Lori. So what he decides is, listen, I did mess up, but here is the book of notes that Franco had. So you can go through it. I don't know what you're going to find, but there is a lithium and a cobalt mining in Minnesota that he was looking at. So this is another lead for Muncie. Remember, he didn't sign the NDA, so he can divulge his information. When he gets to CNN, his old boss, who suspended him without pay, not fired him, is telling him, we want emotion. When you go out there and expose this, have some emotion. But Muncie said, nah, I'm going out there and I'm exposing Rodney. Now, he does talk about revitalize. He talks about the cobalt mining in Minnesota. And he also talks about how these people are very high powered and after him. And they're really not trying to make a difference. They're really out there trying to protect their assets and benefit from everything they're doing. Now, as he did mention, he's out here risking his life. I personally would have signed that NDA and just wished for the best with that $5 million. Probably would have left the country and said to hell with all of it. But Muncie is a better man than me. He's on CNN telling it all. This is very risky. After his CNN expose, he goes down to a bar, grabs a drink. He has a lot on his mind. He may have just lost $5 million. His ex-wife doesn't want him around. But when he leaves to go back to his car, he's paranoid. He thinks everyone is after him because what he did was risk his life for the betterment of America. So as he's walking, he thinks two people are following him. If you remember, he still has this burner car, this stolen car with a baseball bat. So he rushes to the back seat, grabs the bat, only to turn around and realize nobody was following him. He's losing it right now, but you gotta keep your head on the swivel. Demetrius has been reluctant to come and stay with his father because he feels like his dad isn't doing anything. He's not doing enough, even though his dad is risking his life. He's saying, you need to grab a gun and go spray up the block like you did over at Aunt Nadia's house. Mom is in the hospital and you're not doing anything. You just don't understand it, Dad. But this young man doesn't understand how the world works. You can't just go out there and blah, blah, blah people because then you're going to be in jail, jail, jail. And there's no coming back from that, especially for a black man. But Demetrius, he's upset. So he leaves the house and he says Polo is coming to pick him up. In Muncie, there's really nothing much he can do. He wants to be there, but his son just doesn't understand. And applying too much pressure is just going to push him further away. The very next day, Demetrius is at the house. Muncie's out running, getting his exercise in because you can't solve these cases on a empty stomach or not being in shape. Well, someone throws a letter up under the door and it's telling where exactly Rodney is going to be. Well, Demetrius is the one that sees it and he finds out that his dad left a gun in the drawer, in a pot, in the kitchen. So he grabs that gun and he leaves the note on the table because unlike his father, he's going to get something done. He's going after Rodney. Demetrius shows up to this warehouse where Rodney and his crew is supposed to be having a meeting. Now, Muncie is calling around asking Callie where she's at. They're about 30 minutes away from here because they found out that Demetrius took this gun and it seems like Demetrius is big Demetrius right now and he's standing on big business. Now, I don't know what he's going to do with that Thule, but he's tired of playing and he already told his father, you need to do something. Or I'm gonna do something for mom. When Muncie gets there, we see Demetrius kicking the fence. And I'm like, what the heck is this kid doing? He could probably just climb over it. Or in the bottom left, there's actually a little hole that he can crawl through. But he's kicking the fence and Muncie shows up. And he's like, get off me, Dad. He's like, give me the gun, son. You don't need to do this. Give me the gun, Craig. Give me the gun. Use these. You live to fight another day. But this isn't the fight you want to fight with your fist. You're going to have to fight this in the courts. You're going to have to fight this on television, in the media, the public eye. And well, he gets the gun, and Demetrius, he walks off, and Callie's got to save him. But this leaves the gun to Muncie, and we got to figure this out. When Muncie goes into this warehouse, he uses a crowbar to break in. He sees that it's empty, but in one room, it looks like a server room. And this is where you want to have your servers at, in an open room where you can get a lot of ventilation, keep them cool, you know, not too much heat because it's already going to heat up the place. But we see Rodney, and he tells him, don't even think about it. But Rodney turns around and tells him straight up, listen, if you unalive me, there are hundreds of me out here. With global warming, we're trying to save the earth. We're trying to cool it down. So yeah, I may have hired some people like Julia and other hitmen to take people out, but this is for the bigger cause. Now, I don't know about you. I do believe in global warming, but taking people out to help your cause, it ain't it. But we do see that Muncie has a flashback. Well, it's not even a flashback. He flashed out and envisioned shooting this guy, but he doesn't do it. After Muncie leaves him, the whole deck of cards starts to crumble. Remember, Lori, she infiltrated the forge. Well, she went and told on all of them. The feds come and do a sweep of them, get them off the street. Now, the guy that helped her and gave her the hard drive, he actually escapes. But one by one, we're seeing everyone start to fall. But remember, Rodney said there are hundreds of him. So even if he got arrested, acquitted, there's always going to be someone else to fill in that spot. But at least we're getting the supremacist group off of the streets. Lori and her kids, they're packing up. They're leaving. Now, they got that $5,000. Stewards are supposed to give them a lot more, but that didn't happen. They're leaving. And it turns out, even though Rodney, no charges were on him, the guy that escaped from the forge, he actually unalived Rodney. So Rodney definitely didn't make it out either. But it looks like it's going to be a fairy tale ending for everybody. And the last thing we see on our screen is a black family coming together, because nothing brings us together more than adversity. They all go out to a park. Demetrius, Callie, their father, Muncie. This is where his mom used to be at. They used to drink rum and Coke. He used to just sip on a Coke and listen to them yap it up. And then we see Elena come out here. So even though she asked for some distance, it looks like we're ending on a good note and the fairy tale is over with. Now, this is potentially setting up for a season 2, because we did see a car drive off and Muncie was a little bit nervous, but maybe not. Maybe it's just a limited series. Maybe this is the happy ending we always been asking for, but I don't know. Only time will tell. All right, there you go. 8 days, 8 recaps of the madness. Do you believe that there's going to be a season 2? Because why would they set it up like this where we see a car drive off with his nervousness? And also, why would Rodney say, when I'm gone, there's just going to be 100 others of me that are going to pop back up? Let me know what you think. I'm MoedotJ. That was 8 days. The first 8 days of December, we're doing 31 days of Netflix shows and movies. We got Squid Games this month. We got a lot of stuff to cover. We got movie reviews that are going to be dropping. 31 days, 31 Netflix shows and movies. I'm MoedotJ. If you like this kind of content, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. I'm out. Jimmy on the beat, boy.